How to prove the existence of God. The outer way is divided into two types. The first type is the philosophical proof. The second type is the simple proof. We will be speaking about the simple proof in this lesson. When one ponders over the order and organization between things, it proves to any pondering person that it must have an organizer. For example, consider the way the planets are aligned around the sun, and the way the earth is positioned in relation to the sun. If the earth was slightly ever closer to the sun, it would be far too hot to live on, and life would be impossible. Similarly, if the earth was slightly further from the sun, it would be too cold for life. The earth is positioned perfectly in order to support life. Another example is that of the gradual change of day and night. At dawn, light gradually pierces the curtains of darkness, and at night, light slowly leaves to give us darkness. Can you imagine waking up at a time when the sky is totally black, and then suddenly within a few seconds it becomes as bright as midday? This gradual change can only occur because of the precise rotation of the earth along its axis, in the most gentle and calculated of manners, so that we feel the least of discomfort. Furthermore, the fact that everything in the universe works in harmony with one another is proof that there can only be one unique God and Lord creating and sustaining the creations. For example, if we look at trees, the trees hold the soil together, and at the same time the earth provides the tree with nutrients. The tree then provides humans with oxygen to breathe, and we provide the trees with carbon dioxide to breathe. The leaves of the tree filter the air by removing dust and absorbing other pollutants like carbon monoxide. Fallen leaves make excellent compost that enriches soil. Earthworms bring air to the soil so that the roots of the plants can obtain better oxygen. Rain and water enters the soil and dissolves the nutrients, sending up, feeding the tree into the leaves. Then radiant energy is supplied by the sunlight and is absorbed through the leaves to help it grow. Animals use trees for food and nutrition, and then their waste enters the soil and becomes a fertilizer that also helps the trees and other plants grow. Bees feed on the nectar and pollen of flowers. Worker bees land on the flowers and drink their nectar. The nectar is stored with the bee. In the process of doing this, bees become covered in pollen. When bees fly from one flower to another, pollen is spread from plant to plant. Then the plant will be able to form seeds and reproduce many other plants. After collecting nectar and pollen from many different flowers, bees fly back to their colonies and work together to produce honey. This cycle can go on and on. As an example, if bees were removed from the environment, not only would the plants suffer and expire, but so would many natural animal species that depend upon those plants for their own survival. Loss of honey bees would mean the collapse of the natural ecosystem, and the same goes for trees and other things. Each ecosystem is kept in a perfect balance. Do you think all of this came by itself? Of course not. There must be a unique creator.